there, and welcome to Neophyte.tv, the technology show for the not-so-geeky. My name's Tiffany Young.
And I'm Ben Friedman, and today's show, or at least the first part of today's show, is all about headphones and headsets.
Headphones and headsets.
Headphones and headsets. The two H's of cell phone iPod usage. It's amazing, you know, cell phones and iPods, you know, I only carry an iPhone now, so I have my iPhone and my iPod in one. But I think a lot of people, like yourself, still like to have the two
separate.
Yeah, you've got the iPhone or the phone.
Right.
And then you've got the iPod.
Although I would like them combined. It's just the not the versatility of having a different service provider
that
keeps me separate. But I wish my carrier, and more than anything else, it's about service.
That's
I can't
right.
get the good service
you like
that
Sprint,
I want.
And you want, you'd probably, maybe you'd buy an iPhone if it was on Sprint.
It's just where I live, I get so many dropped calls, I can't afford to keep losing calls. Therefore, it doesn't make sense.
So, first of all, let's take a look at a set of headphones for your iPod or whatever. And these are really nice headphones. These are earbuds by Sennheiser, the good people that make our microphones that we use on the show.
Didn't they sell beer too? Oh, that's Sennheiser.
Yes, Sennheiser, not Anheuser. These are from Sennheiser, and I guess, you know, they're fairly nondescript. What do you think? I mean, just and it comes with a bunch of interchangeable
soft.
Little things, very, very soft. But let me tell you what I like about these.
Okay.
First of all,
please
you know,
tell.
Yeah, I prefer, I don't know how you feel about it, but I prefer the ones with the two equal length strings rather than, have you seen the ones that have a short one over here and then it goes, you know, so the cord goes up one side
right.
and then it goes like around.
I like the equal length.
You like
too.
The equal length ones. So we're both into the equal length things, and it has a little clip in here so you can clip it to your shirt. Here's what I like about this. So after about, I don't know, what is that, about 2.5, maybe 3 feet of cord, you can unplug this and you just have this shorter length. And this is great if you have your iPod on an armband. So you can put these in your ears, like so.
Yeah.
What?
Now those fit you.
What?
Those fit you pretty well.
Well, I have bigger ears.
Yeah.
So they fit well. But it does, am I shouting? I feel like I'm shouting. So if I'm shouting, it's because these things are really good at blocking out the sound. So.
Well, they are really buried in your ear. Can you hear me, Ben?
What? Yes. These are good at isolating sound.
It's like, Grandpa, Grandpa, read my lips, Grandpa. Yeah.
So the whole idea is now if you have an armband, this can just go straight over to your armband. You don't have...
Of course, right here.
You don't have, you know, 6 feet of cable.
Yeah.
Right. Sorry. Was I shouting?
Sure.
6 feet of cable coming off there. However, if you do want to play, you know, put it in your pocket or whatever, you can then attach this extra... Extra, what is that? Like an extra 4 feet?
Right.
That's about 4 feet, 3 feet, 4 feet of cable. And then when you put these together, now you've got a long one that you can put it in your backpack or you can put it in your...
I really like this idea because I use armbands. And when
I do that exercise. You
know. I try.
Yeah.
And these, when the cords are too long, they just swing, you know, when you're running and
yeah.
it's irritating.
Smack you in the face.
Or you have to run it up under your shirt, which is irritating. And what's the extra cord for, really? I mean, you're going from here to here,
right? So, but in case you
don't
want
just
it
in
so
case,
short.
Well,
right.
sure, you know,
when
just
you,
in case.
Yeah,
you've got the extra, so you've got two really sets of headsets.
These sound
in one.
Really, really good too. Now, obviously, there's nothing we can do to show people how good they sound, but let me tell you, I listen to these and they sound really, really good.
Mm-hmm.
They're a little pricier than you know some. They're about $80. But if you're looking for a good set of headphones with that removable cord, I really like these.
Well, it's two in one again.
Two in one.
So, can we just say $40 each?
$40 for the headphones and then $40 more for the included, very expensive extension cable.
Exactly.
That's the Sennheiser CX400s. And they have some cheaper ones as well, but they sent us the 400s. Now, speaking of two in one, these headphones are by a company called V-Moda. And these are the V-Moda Vibe Duos. And these are designed for iPod listeners. Now, they will work in, iPhone listeners. People who have iPhones. They will work in an iPod. You can plug this into your iPod. That kind of defeats the purpose of these. If you take a look, first of all, equal length again, so I like them.
Mm-hmm.
If you take a look at these, halfway down the right-hand side is this little microphone. So if you have an iPod...
Phone?
iPhone, you can plug these in, and then when the phone rings, you slide the little thingy, and you don't have to take your headphones out. you know, you can just talk right into this little microphone down here. The only thing I don't like about this is it's really girly. I don't know if you can see. There's this silver band that looks kind of jewelry. It looks chicky to me.
Yeah, okay. I'll go with that. I think this looks a little chicky. It does.
A little chicky.
But I like this.
Yeah.
If I had an iPhone, this would definitely be on top of my list because I've got the big headset still.
Right.
That with a separate iPod Bluetooth adapter. And, you know, I look like a dork at the gym. I've got the blinking blue headset. It's like a bigger one, too. It's like, it's like the old model.
It's like the big on, you know,
yeah,
NASA.
This would make command. Me look cool.
Right.
What I have now does not.
Right. And, you know, you're going to get better audio quality than you do with Bluetooth because you're not going through that whole Bluetooth link. Now, the earbuds that come with the iPhone have a little switch on them. And I've been told that this one does not have a switch to answer the call. So you still have to grab your phone out of your pocket, slide it to answer the call. But I've been told that the new model of these that are coming out right away, pretty much, will have a little switch here. So you can leave your iPhone in your pocket. Somebody rings, you just squeeze this.
Well, I've noticed.
Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze.
Yeah, it would be nice to just have a little squeeze right there.
Yeah, and then you can just, it's always nice to have a little squeeze. A little squeeze is a good thing. And that way you can answer the call without having to pull the thing out of your pocket.
Yeah, which would be important in functionality.
Moving on to some headsets. The first one we're taking a look at today, this is the Plantronics.
Oh, new Plantronics?
New Plantronics.
Oh, maybe it'll replace my other blue blinky thing.
Maybe. Now, this is the Plantronics Discovery 665. And I tell you, first of all, here's the actual headset. Take a look at that. And it comes with a bunch of different things.
Oh.
Try that on. I don't know if it'll, that's the smallest one, I think. So see if that'll go in
your ear. Did you purposely put the smallest one in here for me?
I did. I want you to try it out and see if you can get that in your ear.
Yeah, actually, that stays good.
Well, and it's light enough. Can you turn this way? Yeah. It's light enough that it's going to, you know, you don't need to have all the hooks and the clips and the
things. It's very light.
It's very, very,
very light.
Yeah. It also doesn't look like you're from Mars. I mean, it looks pretty cool.
It does. I like the ones that are neutral colored. I don't see very many
of
them.
Black, is that good or?
Neutral, like as in beige, like skin tone, flesh colored.
Okay. So you actually don't want to think, you want people to think you're not wearing the thing.
Well, it's just not, I like things to blend. It's kind of like, I don't know, I'd rather have it blend than not. But for me,
if you're African American, this would blend.
Exactly.
Well, African American,
you have to be
with
like
a silver
African-African
streak down the side of your face.
With silver hair.
What if you're an old African American?
So, this actually fits pretty good.
It is. It's very comfortable. Mm-hmm. Now, let me show you. It comes with this is the charging cradle. But the nice thing about the charging cradle, this just slips in here like so, is it's got a little clip on it. See that? So you can, if you want to, carry this around like this or, you know, on your belt. Or if you have a phone case, you can slide this into your side of your phone case. And this stays here. So when somebody calls, you just do like this and you can use it. And then when you're done.
Then is there a button to answer it then?
Yeah, the button's all right here.
Oh, good. Okay. So
you just put it back.
Oh, that's nice.
And then when you go into your car, and I think this is the part you'll like the best. When you go into the car, it comes with this little car charging thingy.
Wow.
And this just attaches like so. Okay. So now you have a car charger. So this goes into your dashboard or whatever, and it's charging all the time. Phone rings, pull it out. This stays in your charger. End of the call, drop it back in. Starts charging up again.
Very nice.
What do you think of that?
That was very creative.
Yeah.
And I like how they had this is important too, the bend.
The bend.
Because sometimes, if you've noticed with design in cars, you can't always get it exactly the way you want
the angle has
it. And
to,
it looks like, could you
angle.
Imagine if you're just sticking out of your cigarette lighter like this, in the back, you know, that wouldn't
That's
work.
That's rather phallic looking, I think.
See,
you
wouldn't
want to have that thing sticking out of
I would
of that
never
angle.
Have even dawned on me to think of that, but nice.
Nice. Yeah.
And Plantronics definitely has a solid name. I've used their products for quite some time and very comfortable.
Now, this has been out for a little while, but they just sent us one here. And this is very cool. You might like this as well. This is by a company called Jawbone.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Jawbone. Yeah.
You've heard of these, right?
Of course. Yeah.
Right. And I've been using this with my iPhone. Very good sound quality on here, but it's a little bigger and not as light as the Plantronics. Mm-hmm. By the way, that Plantronics one was $70.
Oh, thanks.
And this Jawbone is $90. So not a lot of difference in price here.
Well, it just seems like that would fit you better. It just seems like it's just a bigger...
Can you try it on? I don't know if that'll fit. It's on your left ear, and you have to put the hook around your ear and then stuff the thing inside. It's a little more complex to getting in than just this guy.
I have really tiny... Oh, wait, here we go.
Oh, you got it. Yeah, hold on.
Wait.
Now you got to get this whole thing around your ear like so.
Okay, so a little learning curve.
Little learning curve on here. Once you've done it once, it's easy, but... Okay.
Yeah, that one, it's just too big.
It is bigger. I had my wife try this as well, and she says it's a little too big.
Yeah.
But I got to tell you, what you lose in bigness, you make up for in sound quality. Sound is really
good. What you lose in smallness?
What you lose in smallness.
Is that a word?
You make up for in sound quality. It sounds good.
I think this would be better with, this is more of a man's.
You think this is more of a manly
Yeah, if headset. They made that in a women's version a little bit smaller, yeah, that'd be great. I mean, of course, in flesh tone again.
Right.
I like the flesh tone.
So here it is. I don't know if I can get it on with my headphone there.
See, that looks good on you.
You think?
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, quite a fashion statement. Very good noise reduction on this. You know, I can use it in the car and, you know, you don't get a lot of noise.
Mm-hmm.
So I this is, right now, it's my favorite Bluetooth adapter. And I think you would really like this one.
That would work for me, yeah. Correct.
So that would be good. All right, one more thing to look at here. Now, here are your standard iPod headphones.
Which I can't wear.
You can't wear. And this is why I saved this for last.
This is why I have the dorky, blinky,
old-fashioned. Because you have trouble wearing these standard whites. So There's a company called Lobi that makes this earbud accessory. And let me make sure I get the right one for the right ear. So this is a Lobi. Take a look at that.
Oh, no. It looks like a slug.
Well, exactly. And what do you do with the Lobi? Well, you take your... This is... What do you call it? It's like silicon... It's something. It's like...
it's like a big glob of glue that dried.
A glob of glue. Yeah. So what you do is this. This is the... Oops, the wrong one. Let's take this one. You take your headphone and you push it through this little hole. And it'll work with apparently just about any of these earbud type ones. Okay, so now the earbud, can you see that is sitting on the inside? And then you take this and put it around your ear.
This is closer to flesh tone.
Yeah, and it comes in a bunch of colors. We've got a blue one and a pink one. Now turn this way and take a look. Now, you'll notice it doesn't block out the sound as much.
Right, of course not.
When listening to this, I noted, first of all, isn't it amazingly comfortable?
Very comfortable.
You can wear this all day. It's amazingly comfortable. These are all of $12 for a set.
Really?
Yeah.
This is a nice solution.
And if you need to, you can make them smaller. If you kind of wrap it like this, it'll stay smaller. Or if you stretch it out, it'll stay bigger. So you might want to wrap it up a bit for your smaller ears.
Right. Now, actually, the way this works great.
Now, you lose some bass, mm-hmm. I found. You're not going to get as much bass response as having the thing stuffed all the way in your ears. You also don't have the audio isolation. So you can still hear me quite easily.
Right.
And you could even with both on because it doesn't go inside your ear canal. So I love these for cycling because, you know, I'm always worried when I'm cycling with the earbuds in
that
I can't hear traffic and such.
Oh,
you
know, right.
This one, you can still hear.
You could fool the person next to you. There's been plenty of conversations I've been privy to next to on the treadmill when somebody thought my headset was on, but it was not.
Right.
You have to keep a straight face sometimes. It's,
So you're not going to get, I don't think these are great for listening to music because you lose some of the bass and you lose a lot of the volume.
Very comfortable.
But if you like to listen to audiobooks or spoken word or anything like that in a comfortable environment where you can wear them for hours.
Spanish is a second language.
Exactly. That's fantastic.
Yeah, I like that. This was needed, I think.
Definitely. Yeah, I really like this. Those are the Lobis. So we
bucks.
Had here today, we had the Sennheiser CX400s. We had the V-Moda Vibe Duo, and we had the Bluetooth, the Plantronics 665 Discovery, the Jawbone, and the Lobi.
Very
nice.
These.
I'm glad you like them. I thought you would. I when I saw these, I thought, Tiff's going to like these.
I definitely like this because I'm just, you know, I feel like I get excluded from so many choices because I've got small ears.
Small ears.
It's almost like having a handicap.
She suffers from the heartbreak of small ear syndrome.
Small ear syndrome.
So that's all the time we have for this first section, but we have another section coming up right after the break. So please stay tuned.
I don't really know what you just said, but I don't know what you said.
I sent the presentation on the spreadsheet, but next week's presentation.
iPods, including the new iPod Classic, which tops out at 160 megabytes, and the new iPod Touch, which is just like the...
Hi there, I'm Ben Friedman from Neophyte.tv, and for the best sound for your podcasts or office communications, check out the microphones at RevoLabs.com.
And we're back, and in the second spotlight section today, we're going to be looking at some iPod docks. You know, It's a busy day. We've got three all those headphones, and now we've got three iPod docks we're going to look at. And the first two are from the same company, a company called Boink.
Boink.
Yeah.
Boink.
Boink. Out of Europe. That's spelled B-O-Y-N-Q.
Oh,
Boink.
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 I thought you were, could you use that phrase when you're doing stuff anyway? So
like,
when you're,
how do you use that in a sentence?
I thought you were just saying, oh, boink.
Oh, like, boink.
Oh, boink.
Oh, boink. No, these
are
from Boink.
That's a key phrase for anyway.
I see it doesn't actually have the brand on here. This is called the iCube 2. And I got to tell you, these speakers are a little less expensive than some of the other ones. This is $60. Not the sound quality of a Bose. Much more kids' room,
right.
Kitchen, bathroom type of thing.
Oh, yeah, this would be cute.
This one's very cute. In fact, it says on the front of the package here, Pink Supremacy.
Pink Supremacy.
That's the iCube 2 Pink Supremacy.
Actually, that really completely matches your shirt, Ben. Look at that.
Wow.
That's it, yeah. It blends. You're like all lilac.
Okay.
Things look very cute in your room.
Nice little light on the front here, and it has a bass and a treble control here. But again, the bass is not incredible on this unit. So let's.
Well, you wouldn't expect for $60.
Exactly.
You know, you're not paying for $300 unit. So
plug it in. Oh, it's got different the different little dock. It comes with pink little docking adapters. I've got the wrong one in here right now. So let's stick this on here, and there's no remote control. It's just again what you see. Pretty much is what you get. It does come with audio input and output cables,
which is nice.
Which is nice. So it comes with the cables to hook it up to your stereo or to put a normal CD player in here.
Really, right now in every room next to our TVs, I have one of these. Not this exact model,
but at least nice to have something in every room. Yeah.
Right, because no matter what room we're in, you know, I can get on
TV.
So
here we go. Let me crank the volume up. Ooh,
I like the light.
Crank the bass up a little here.
Yeah, here's the treble. That was perfect. Britney Spears for this book. It's like a teen room. We're more than
just friends. I mean, it sounds a bit radio, talk radio-y.
It does.
But for $60, I think it's
right
a great
thing.
Right
there sounds good. Now, keep in mind, this is a huge room.
Yeah.
So in a small room, it's probably not going to sound too bad.
Yeah, for background music like this level, you're right. It sounds good.
Yeah.
But you crank it up a bit. So it's got some volume.
Poor Britney Spears.
Poor Britney. Let's have a quick moment of silence for.
I know we need a few minutes.
I got to tell you, it's got some volume. It doesn't have a lot of bass.
No.
That's all, and it doesn't have.
Yeah.
It has a line out, so you could put a subwoofer in, but you know, it needs that subwooferness.
Or if you're connecting to your TV, and your TV has some decent sound, then you're in
good
shape.
But it's $60, so you know, it's not. It's maybe not. You know, what are you expecting? Are you expecting earth shattering? You know, I think for a kid's room, or small room.
It's perfect.
It's a perfect little thing. Now,
right. What do you want to spend $400 for a small room anyway?
Right, exactly. Or on your kids. $400 on your kids, you got to be careful.
Oh, yeah. Those little suckers.
Now, this is another one. And you got a kind of neat design, right? This is
just I like the design.
This one is looks kind of race car like.
Space-like.
Space-like?
Mm-hmm.
A little space-like. Again, basically very similar functionality, line in, line out, treble volume on here. And. Again, I'm going to plug this in here. And now this one is called, Boink Saber. And it says right on the box, pour homme.
Pour homme?
Or for
men.
For
your home.
Pour homme means for men.
Oh, it does.
Yeah.
Oh, I would say for your home.
No. Pour homme means for men.
Well, I guess French. I guess it means French.
So you can see it's got these speakers on the side.
Elective.
That's okay. That's
in
precious.
In school.
So here it is again. And again, these are real docks. They're not, you know, you don't have to go with a line. Yeah, you
and this has video out, of course.
Video out, although I'm not sure if that video out will work with these new iPods.
Right.
Old iPods, yes. New iPods. I don't think so. I don't think it's going to work.
I would be really upset if I got my new iPod home and couldn't watch it on my TV.
Yeah, so, but you still can. Obviously, the primary response here is this is supposed to be a speaker.
Hey, Ben, what's the purpose of them not putting video out on the new iPods?
Well, they have video out, but you have to buy the special Apple cable.
That's right. You have to spend more money.
Spend more money
again,
with
Apple. The reason why I still... Okay.
They may fix that. They may change it. Maybe it's a firmware thing that
can
change.
I think that's not really
There's
fair.
There's enough of a backlash.
Like, we don't spend enough money already. And be
So let's crank this one up a little bit and see.
Oh, that's good.
I'll turn the bass off a bit. One more bass.
Yeah. No, you're not Britney.
She really isn't that innocent, you know.
Well, no.
Good volume. Yeah. So I got to tell you, for this one's $90.
Yeah.
Is it $90? Yeah, $90. Still under $100 with
yep.
a real full docking connectivity, charges up and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And
that
it
sounds pretty good.
Has a dock connector yeah. if you want to attach it to your computer so you yeah. can sync while you're doing that. You know, very similar functionality to this guy. Just a bit bigger speakers, a little more power.
Well, for the $30 difference, I mean, there's a big difference.
Yes, but
I
this
think.
One's poor home. You cannot have this.
Oh, yeah.
It's not poor
for
femme.
Men.
That would be poor femme. This is for poor femme.
Or for your home.
Yes, even though we match. This is poor home. For men, only.
For men, okay.
So well, I think these are good value. Are these audiophile speakers? No.
Right.
But they are good value speakers.
I agree. It's hard to find good speakers that have decent quality for under $100.
It is. And you know? These are decent quality.
Yes.
That decent is, I think, the word that describes it.
And it comes with the cables and your, you know, some interchange thingies for the different iPods and
check out this bad boy.
My goodness, that's bright. So where's my sunglasses? No, just kidding.
This is let me plug this in. This is from M Station. This is the M Station 2.1 Orb.
I am sensing in your future. I can see.
I know. You know what it's like? It's like, okay, he lines up the shot and strike. Okay. It's pretty much the exact same size as a bowling
ball. How about a disco ball?
This one does have a remote. The Boink one's no remote.
Okay.
But this one, I think you will be impressed with the sound for a small little unit.
Do you think that it's the way in which the unit is actually shaped, the ball?
It does get you a nice, a very wide dispersion of
right,
sound.
Right, because you're all the way over here
right.
on this side. And you have the bass back here.
Base
bag,
so
I would say
base port on the back.
Design yeah. makes this.
I think you're right. This has no line out on here. So
no
not,
video.
Video out. So this is just for audio.
No
but
video.
It does come with, no video, but it does come with a remote.
Okay. So in exchange for video, we're gonna,
right.
you can control it from across the room.
Let me crank this up. Whoops.
Uh-oh.
Did I just pull the plug out? I think I did.
Ooh. Party foul, party foul.
I just pulled the plug out.
Where's the mute? Yeah. Yeah, that sounds pretty good.
Now, I think there's a lot more bass,
yeah.
right? I mean, this
yeah.
one's got bass.
Well, you can feel
you can
it
feel
back
it,
here.
Yeah, I can hear it, too. And, you know, we put this in our kitchen in the corner, and it really filled up the whole room.
I would say so.
Yeah, it's a nice sounding unit.
Yeah. Now, pricing on this one?
A little more pricey. $130.
$129. So, well, at least we can really gauge the differences between $60, $90, and $130.
Well, and it's this again, if you turn around in the back here, it's mm-hmm. got this subwoofer in the back.
Mm-hmm.
I think that makes all the difference in the world.
Now, I'm not crazy about the color, but I like the design.
It comes in several colors.
Ah.
But only one design.
Right. Well, the design's fine.
You like the yeah. circle?
It doesn't really blend with your kitchen. Unless you have your room done in retro.
If you rub the front, you get good luck. Like a Buddha.
Buddha. Good one. Yeah, you'd have to do a retro room.
Yes. And you know what's kind of cool is, you know, maybe if you buy like the green iPod and the green... One, you can like match your iPod to your speakers.
You can match.
Again, this comes with a bunch of different inserts.
Dress your iPod.
Let me pop this up here so you can, you know, and these are all custom color, right? So here's the, mm-hmm. the iPod, the insert for the iPod Classic and that we're using here. And
very nice.
Yeah. So that's $129 for the M Station mm-hmm. Orb, which I think is the best sounding of the ones today, also the most expensive.
I still think they need video out just in case because you lose... Those people in which want to put it next to their in a TV
this
room.
Is true. Although it does still have line in, so you can plug a CD player or something else or your computers into this and get that. 2.1, it's the M Station 2.1 Orb for $129. And then we had the Boink iCube 2,
mm-hmm.
which was the pinky one. That's this one here for $60. And the Boink Saber Pour Homme.
You're practicing your French. Very good.
$90.
Sounds like por favor.
Yeah,
I'm mixing up my Spanish with my French.
I think you mean s'il vous plaît.
What?
S'il vous plaît.
What's that mean?
Please.
Oh, please.
In French.
Oh, so yeah. Do you know a lot of French? Am I learning something new about
getting just to enough know to get my you? Face slapped.
Can you know all that? Yeah, right. Probably me too on accident. I've picked up a few Spanish words, repeated them, and then got horrified looks and realized that was not exactly what I thought it was in the first place.
Right. That's all the time we have for this week. Please visit our website, www.neo-fight.tv. Leave us some comments.
Yeah, we love your comments.
We do love the comments, and everyone loves to read those. So leave some comments on our website. And if you happen to have an extra moment, take a look at this.
Hey, I'm Andy Walker. Have you just bought a new computer with Windows Vista on it? Or maybe you've got an old XP computer that you upgraded. Well, we've just created an amazing new DVD. It'll teach you everything you need to know about the new operating system from Microsoft. It's called Getting Started with Windows Vista. In this DVD, there are three sections. One is out of the box, what you need to do as soon as you start up Vista. Number two is Vista Essentials, things you need to know every day to make your computer experience amazing. Antivirus, security, all kinds of new features that Vista offers. And finally, geek tips and tricks, things you need to know that nobody else will have told you to make you a Vista guru. For more information, check out our website at gettingstartedvideo.com.